Hello everyone, today I will be explaining you about the qualities of space, that is, what are the qualities that the space should have in such a way that it should be suitable for satellites, and also what are the components which are more strong, or what is the reliability of the component. So that we'll be discussing today. Now let us see at the first slide. So at the end of this session, the outcome is student will be able to explain different types of space and its characteristics, as well as the type of testing that the electronic components have undergone. Now before going to the next slide, let us recall the characteristics of space. So characteristics of space, in the sense, what is the space condition there? So whether it is clear space or whether the space is going to have certain winds, you can call it as solar winds, or whether the space is going to be not very well. So that is the characteristics of space, and also the different types of orbits. So different types of orbits, in the sense, suppose if it is a geosynchronous orbit, or suppose if it is a lower earth orbit, or suppose if it is a higher earth orbit, or suppose if it is a medium earth orbit. So what type of orbit it is? So it depends upon mainly the distance from the earth surface. So different types of orbits have been classified depending upon the height from the surface of the earth. So we all know that basically the types of orbits in satellite communication are lower earth orbit, that is LEO orbit, medium earth orbit, that is MEO orbit, or higher earth orbit, that is HEO orbit. So further, there are orbits are there like geosynchronous orbit, or the GEO orbit, you can call it as GEO orbit. Now let us see the basic definitions. So what is space? Space is basically the area, so which is going to have at an altitude, so of which the aerodynamic force does not contain. It means that the aerodynamic forces which are required for the flying of objects like aircrafts, so such forces, they are not present in the space. So that is what we say, space is the area where the lack of aerodynamic forces. Then airspace. So airspace is nothing but it is the region, or it is you can say that the area below 100 kilometer from the earth surface. So that is usually the atmosphere of the earth. So it is going to come under the airspace. Now outer space. So outer space, it is nothing but the region between 100 kilometers and 42,000 kilometers. So this outer space, it is also called as cosmic space. So cosmic space is the space where most of the satellites, especially the GEO satellites, are present. So that is the outer space region we are going to use for our satellites. Now what is the deep space? So deep space means it is the region above 42,000 kilometers, and it is not used. So in the sense, it is not used for satellite communication. So means the cosmic space, that is the communication satellites, especially the communication satellites meant for audio video broadcasting. So those kind of broadcasting satellites, or suppose if any transmission of message or the video, so that kind of region, that is the outer space. Whereas deep space, we do not use the communication satellites. So apart from communication satellites, whatever are there, so they fall under the deep space region. Now let us look at the qualities of space. So qualities of space basically indicate the space condition, that is the condition of the space. So usually in space there will be a variation in temperature. It means whether the light, or you can say if at all in the presence of light the temperature is more, or in the absence of light the temperature is less. In the sense, always there is variation in temperature in the space is there. So second point is that there is no certainty in the space. So note certainty in the sense the space region, so it may be clouded with certain meteoroids, or it may be contains certain those are winds, that is space winds you can say. So there is no certainty at all, means we cannot predict the space condition, that is the space, it cannot be uniform at all times. So third condition is that eclipses. So there may be chances that the eclipse may occur, that is the solar eclipse may occur or the lunar eclipse may occur. So under these conditions, the satellite designer, he has to design the satellite in such a way that it has to withstand the space qualities, that is the uncertainty of the space region, that will be handled by the designed satellite. So now let us see what are the equipment's reliability. In the sense, suppose if a satellite designer is there, so the satellite designer, he is going to have two concepts in his mind. First of all, the application of the satellite, for what purpose it is used, whether the satellite is used for communication purposes, or whether the satellite is used for mobile communication purposes, or whether the satellite is used for navigational purposes, or whether the satellite is used for audio video broadcasting. So it depends upon the application at which the satellite designer has to consider his design. And second most important is that the cost. The satellite cost, it plays a very much important role. That is, the satellite designer, he has to keep in mind in order to minimize the cost. Now, usually the lifespan of the satellite, so it depends upon the application, that is the type of application for which purpose you are going to use. So that is, if at all if it is a communication satellite, so the lifespan of the satellite must be 18 years or more than 18 years. Or if the satellite is meant for any audio video broadcasting, then it has to be sustained, or its lifespan should be 8 to 10 years. So keeping these two factors in mind, that is the lifespan of the satellite as well as the cost of the satellites, the satellite designer has to look after the components, so which are reliable as well as which are very much having the power to withstand the space qualities. The satellite designer, he has to consider, so what are the quality of the equipments he has to make use of while building the satellite. So there are certain models which are very useful in order to determine the quality of the components which are used to build the satellites. So if at all if a satellite designer, he is going to build the satellite, then which components he has to select, as well as what are the tests that the components has to undergo. So those tests are mechanical model. Basically the components will be tested with respect to its mechanical properties, so whether it is flexible or not in the rigid environment. Then second thing, electrical properties. What is the maximum current, or what is the maximum voltage that it has to withstand? Then what are the electrical properties of the component, so whether they are well suitable for the satellite or not. Then third one, thermal model. As I said in the earlier slide, the temperature variation in the space, it is very much. So In order to withstand such variation in temperature, the components are fed to the thermal testing. Now, let us look at the companies, or let us look at the what you can say, the laboratories in India which are going to test these components. So first of all, the ISRO's laboratories, that is Indian Space Research Organization, especially division, that is Electro-Optics System, Bengaluru, it is responsible for the design as well as development of electro-optic sensor for spacecraft use. So usually the sensors, it includes star sensors, sun sensors, so different types of sensors, so which can be used for processing the electronics. Then optics system, so it basically includes certain remote sensing cameras such that we can sense the remote areas, so which are usually not detectable by the human being, so we can sense that using the remote sensing cameras. And also there are certain radio meters, so different types of sensors as well as radio meters, as well as the infrared detectors, as well as MEMS based inclinometers are used in order to build the satellite. So these are the references I have referred, that is the satellite communication textbook by Timothy Pratt, then the websites I have visited, that is www.waves.com, so you can see the website, then you can also get the information from NPTEL courses, then the textbook, that is Antennas and Wave Propagation by John D. Krause. For the knowledge regarding the sensors, you can refer this textbook. Thank you.